Which is the best wire you can use to make stop motion puppet armatures? A common fear any animator has is if the puppet breaks during the animation. And as you may know, wire is not forever, but if you follow some steps, it will last longer, and sometimes even it's possible to finish a whole short film using the same puppet. You want a flexible wire, but not that soft that it doesn't hold in place. You also want a wire without memory. That means that when you bend the wire, it stays in place and it doesn't go back. Normally steel has more memory. And finally, the perfect wire must allow you to bend a lot of times in the same spot without breaking. Those are the materials that I use more often in the workshop, starting for the softer, tin, lead, aluminium, copper, brass, and steel. There are more materials, but those are the more normal. And between them, aluminium is the one that performs better for stop motion animation, because it's in the middle between the softer to the harder, so it has a good bending abilities. As I showed you in a previous video, I use different thickness depending on the part of the puppet that I'm working in. So, for example, fingers will have the thinnest one, and then legs needs a thicker and a stronger one. When I say aluminium wire, it's not any aluminium, it must be a particular one. It must be bare aluminium, near to the purity, and without any treatment. So I recommend you to buy always aluminium for stop motion in stop motion stores like Kinetic Armatures, because most of the wires that you will find in hardware stores are treated to maintain an extra shiny surface, and those break with a fast snap. This one is the coil that I use the most. It's the 1.6 millimeters in thickness. In this coil there are 30 meters. To make a puppet you need around 1 meter and a half. So with this coil you could make around 15 puppets. The type of wire that you use is really important. So let's find out how many times we can bend this wire and other wires to know which are the best. And to do that, I will make a machine to reproduce the same movement every time. Thank you. it. Here we are, our Arduino. I have one CNC shield to program it faster. Let's make some code now. After some tweaking from the code of Arduino's side, I adjust my revolutions. Finally, the machine is ready. It was a little bit tricky and I spent like 3 hours to make this work and properly test the wires. So here you are. This is the thing that it has, a NEMA 17 motor. This kind of lever will turn left to right to bend the wire in here, and the idea is that we will fit. Let me see. The idea is that we will insert the wire in here. Screw the wire in this part here. And then the idea is that in here it will bend. First wire, let's set the tension. Okay, ready? You can come closer so you can see it. Nice. Perfect. Let's plug Arduino and count it. Broken. This is the worst aluminium ever. It's the aluminium that you find in the hardware stores, and it's used to make ringy things and other things for jewelry. It's anodized, but it's not good for stop motion because it breaks really fast, as you will see now. Closer. Bang. Vale. Galvanized steel. Vale, aluminio, plomo, aluminio y mata. Ah. Those are all the materials bending in the machine, all them using 1 millimeter in thickness or diameter. So now you know which one lasts longer or allows you to bend more times. For me, and that's a personal choice, the best one is aluminum because it's in the middle between the softer and the harder, so it has a nice feeling. It handles really nice the weight. It also has very little memory, so when I move it, it stays in place. And it lasts so long, so it's a good choice for me. That's it for today's video. Hope it has been useful for you. Please subscribe and consider supporting this channel in Patreon. And see you in the next video.